The daughter of a Hong Kong bookseller detained in China is criticizing Britain for ignoring the erosion of freedom in its former colony. In an op-ed in The Guardian newspaper, Angela Gui, daughter of Gui Minhai, writes, 21 years ago, then British Prime Minister John Major pledged that Britain would continue to defend the freedoms granted to Hong Kong by the joint declaration against its autocratic neighbor. Today, instead of holding China to its agreement, Britain glances down at its shoes and mumbles about the importance of trade. Now, Gui has been appealing for her father's release since 2015, when she said that he disappeared while in Thailand. Months later, he appeared on Chinese state TV, saying he voluntarily handed himself over to Chinese authorities. Activists believe Gui, a Swedish national, was detained by China for publishing books critical of Beijing. The case has sparked fears over freedom of the press, as well as illegal arrests in Hong Kong. Now, earlier today, I spoke to Carrie Lam, the incoming chief executive of Hong Kong, who was selected by a largely pro-Beijing committee in March. We had a wide-ranging conversation about the handover and Hong Kong's relationship with mainland China. And in this clip, I gauge her reaction on the bookseller incident.
I do share the concern of some people that these sort of reported incidents will give rise to sort of anxiety and fear of the one country, two systems, this high degree of autonomy, this rule of law in Hong Kong being eroded. But at the end of the day, we need evidence before we could actually conclude what actually has happened. But even on the basis of perceptions and fears, I think as the chief executive, I will feel obliged to come up and to speak about my concerns and worries and to assure people of Hong Kong and of course the international community that enforcement of laws in Hong Kong is something to be carried out by our own law enforcement agencies.
Mm. Angela Gui, we've spoken to her at CNN. She's the daughter of one of the missing Hong Kong booksellers, Gui Minhai, who is still detained in China. And she has been campaigning for his release. And she's been asking the world, do not forget my father. Do you have any words of comfort for her?
Well, I think as the country is now pledging to really govern by the rule of law, well, we should really be more sympathetic and perhaps be more understanding as the thing evolves in the mainland of China. But as far as Hong Kong's position is concerned, one country, two systems means one country, two systems. We are duty-bound to safeguard the Hong Kong system. But it would not be appropriate for us to go into the mainland or to challenge what happens in the mainland. That has to be dealt with in accordance with the mainland systems.
So you would not be able to pledge action, but what about just, again, words of comfort?
Well, of course, I sympathize with a girl, because as a mother and myself, if any of my close relatives with that sort of situation, then even out of humanitarian and compassionate grounds, it is only right for me to say the words that I've said. But at the end of the day, we must respect the rule of law in respective jurisdictions.
That was part of my conversation with incoming Hong Kong Chief Executive Carrie Lam. And here is how the daughter of missing bookseller Gui Minhai reacted. She describes the response of the Hong Kong government as, quote, silent acceptance, and calls her father's alleged abduction an obvious breach of one country, two systems.